What up, homies? It's me, Jonathan Moline, and today's footage you'll see Florida Vlog Part 3, and we shot it at Animal Kingdom. I went on a couple of rides, and the Avatar boat ride went on that, soaked people when they came off of a river raft ride that I rode earlier. I went on a lot of other cool things, and I filmed a lot of animals in this sort. There's some shaky footage during the safari thing, because there was a lot of bumps. But I hope you enjoy this footage I'm about to show you. And yeah, till then, stay frosty, my friends. See you in the next video. Enjoy the Animal Kingdom video. Peace.
To wrap around branches, pulling off the leaves, as well as cleaning out their eyes, ears, and nose. Oh, wow. Now, we're coming up, we're going to find a very cool animal. We're going to pass by a black rhino here in just a minute. What's for me this next turn is going to be over on our left. You can actually see first one already. So over on your left, kind of between that pointed rock and a tree. Not the best view of that. We're going to come to the second one. All right, over here on your left, find that one. It's right up against the rocks. Now, typically, black rhinos will weigh in between 3,000 and 4,000 pounds. However, for their size, they are a very fast animal. When they charge at speeds of 35 miles per hour. They're definitely not the most social rhino. They are usually going to be found alone. We are in luck. Later on today, once we head to the East Savannah, we can maybe find some white rhinos out there. What's a little black rhino would be?
Pause till we get more.
There are a couple hippos that are just at the surface on that back far right side. I'll talk about hippos here in just a minute, but I also wanted to point out
these
pelicans that are on the land. Those pelicans are going to be pink year-round, but as mating season gets closer, their colors on their back will get just a little bit brighter. Like a little blush. Now if you look over to your left, you're going to find a whole load of Nile hippos in the eye on the left side of that island. Hippos, they are mostly pure muscle, who have been known to weigh as much as 9,000 pounds. So rather than swimming in the river, they tend to run and jog along the bottom of the water. Hippos are all super fond of their rivers and don't love to leave them. If they do, it's usually because they're looking for food. They'll venture as far as 6 miles to find that. And they are herbivores, so mostly eat aquatic plants and grasses. On average, hippos will eat around 85 pounds of food a day.
This is cool.
Alright, now just over here, we're gonna head over Croc Bridge. If you look out to your left, you can see a Nile crocodile there on the land, but there is one in the water as well. Now the Nile crocodile is the largest crocodilian species in Africa. They weigh in at 500 pounds and grow to be between 16 all the way up to 20 feet. Not the same length of a giraffe is tall. Really cool thing about this crocodile is they can eat as much as half of their body weight in one single sitting. They mostly eat fish, but they're not picky eaters. They're very opportunistic hunters that will have one of these strongest bite forces in the animal kingdom at 2,000 pounds of pressure per square inch. But when they want to, they can still be very gentle. These ones we're looking at, they are the Maasai giraffe, the world's tallest land animal, with some adults that stand as high as 20 feet. Now they are very quick. When they want to run, just like the black rhinos we saw, giraffes too will run at speeds of 35 miles per hour.
It was too soon!
When it comes to giraffe, most of their height will really come from their neck. It makes up around 10 feet. However, in the neck of a giraffe, they will still have the same amount of vertebrae as us. It's 7. Theirs are just quite a bit bigger. Each one of their vertebrae are going to grow to be around a foot in length each.
Oh, big birds over here.
Looks like vultures to me.
Yep. That's some vultures.
Alright, so over on our left side, other than the kind of birds that are out here, if you look over to the right side of that rock den, laying down, there's a pack of African painted dogs that are out there.
Oh yeah, African doggies over there.
Now, those painted dogs, they are some of the most successful hunters, not only in Africa, but the entire world. They have an average hunting success rate of between 80 to 90%.
Oh, I hope you got a photo of that. Come on, you've got
some. Other packs do get to be pretty big, around 30 members. They're led by an alpha male and an alpha female. Now, before I talk too much about the giraffe, we're going to overpost them in a few minutes, but one of my not a couple more species that we're going to be coming up on, they're going to be on our left side. So first up, you're going to find these sable antelope. They have those really skinny backwards pointing horns. They are actually the symbol of our reserve. And then here, these really big curved horns are the Ankole cattle. Tip to tip, their horns are 8 feet in length, but they're very light. They weigh just under 10 pounds. Their horns are mostly hollow on the inside with a honeycomb-like structure that will house a lot of blood vessels that they can then regulate their body temperatures through. Alright, so we can find a few more giraffe out to you on our left side.
I got it.
If we're lucky with one of them, we can maybe see their tongue. They have the same prehensile one that I talked about with you a copy later, a little bit earlier on. Their tongues are super long, they're about 21 inches in length. But what's so cool about them is the color of it. It's like a dark blue, deep purple shade. It's because the giraffe's tongue will have a lot of extra melanin in it to help protect it from sunlight. These wildebeest here on our right, like you said, it's called a confusion herd altogether. They are the second most densely packed mammal in a group aside from us, with their numbers in the wild reaching as high as 1.5 million members. They really don't have the best eyesight, they all tend to blindly follow one another. So when the group is going to lay down for the night, over their backs you can see a lot of dirt and stuff covering them. That stuff will act as a natural sun block. They have some very sensitive skin, so figures where elephants will really prefer the rain and very cloudy days to be the most active. Then we are going to head over to the other end of their territory to look for a few more that could be out there. There are quite a few that are here on the reserve.
Filming all this stuff.
After we get over there, we'll just tell you guys about a very cool conservation trail that are out here.
I got it.
That baby's a little big, but it just loves hanging out with mama. Aww. So if you look to your left, laying down, you can see two cheetahs. They're right in the center of that grass. Hot and as we can use Savannah today. You can't see a third cheetah out there in that right corner walking around. It's called a coalition of cheetahs. You can find this baby right there scratching all those rocks. No, I'll talk about the rhino safety in just a minute, but a couple more things about these cheetahs. We're coming up on two more cheetahs together over on our left. It's called a coalition. They are the world's fastest land animal. They're going to reach speeds of 70 miles per hour in just 3 seconds, and they can maintain that for 100 yards at a time. Now, with the rhinos we just saw, that baby is one of 3 baby white rhinos here that we can look for. They're all part of a species survival program. Well, I'll tell you about it in just a minute, but actually, another cool animal, we're going to come across the lion today. You can see her laying down at the top of the rocks. Here on the left. Now, there's the lioness, the female. We can tell she's missing the big fluffy mane around her neck the male would have. It's so nice we're going to see a lion out today at all. They are normally a very sleepy animal. They sleep for 20 hours a day.
That's awesome.
They're much more active around nighttime because it's a lot cooler. They don't expend as much energy overheating. It exceeds ours by 6 full times. Now that lioness, she's absolutely a big cat. Big thing that makes a big cat is being able to roar. Her roar. Now that mane on his neck alone will weigh as much as 40 pounds. And if you guys have by chance seen the live action version of The Lion King, Simba was based off of that guy right there in Africa. And I like to consider them to be the recyclers of nature, seeing as they will reuse other animals' burrows rather than doing it their own. Now one more animal to pass by here in the savannas, one of the lesser known ones that we're coming across. On your right, these really fuzzy animals are the water bucks. You can probably guess from their name, they love water. But since I'm a good source, they don't really ever leave it. But if they do need to travel, they will actually use rivers just like we use highways. Let's get in the water, go for the ride, go where they need to go. Now we are going to head out.
is cool. Good.
Yes, so that's the mimicry right off the bat, right? They can even introduce themselves. This one up front is Molly. No, she's Molly. Molly.
Hello.
Hello. Molly.
Molly.
Good job. There we go. What's your name?
Gabriella.
Gabriella. Gabby for short. And they've grown up around people. They've lived here at the Bird Show for a long time, and they have learned eight. Okay, I don't know where she learned that one from. But they have learned a bunch of stuff.
Meow! Meow!
Apparently they are cats. That was a very good cat impression. Okay,
this is good.
What else do you girls want to
show? Oh my God, I want to show. Meow, meow!
That's sick.
That is a Komodo dragon. That is so cool. Anyways, Animal Kingdom. Let's check some more stuff out. More Komodo dragon. It's sick.
Way up there.
Ow!
On the top of the rocks there.
Top of the rocks, right there.
Over here.
Follow that road there.
Oh, sorry,
that
sorry.
Goes up, that ends up.
Yeah, I see.
Yeah.
That's sick.
So if you're in Animal Kingdom, you just saw me soak them on that river ride, which we did earlier. We're on it. I was on a few rides. Couldn't film them all, but yeah, I'm having fun.
There's two there.
Yeah,
you can have
roads or places where we might have added
obstacles for them. Oh, cool. So you can,
they do some
things
in Costa Rica
for
spots.
We
have them in Florida for our Florida Panthers, or where I'm from in Maine, we have them.
Looks like he's about to shed skin. That's cool.
Yeah.
These giant bats are Malayan flying foxes, fruit bats. That is the biggest bat I have ever, ever seen. That is really cool.
And they want to keep the genetics good, so they have a specific couple. So these guys are basically...
That's really cool.